Hello everybody and welcome to I Scrap Happy Video. It's finally here. I ordered my Imagine on launch night and I just got it. I'm super excited and I would love to share with you guys some of the stuff that I've learned so far. So this is it. It's huge compared to my expression, which is, as you can see, that's the width of it. This is the width of your Imagine. It's like twice the size of your expression, but it's really cool. I'm loving it already. I've been reading the Cricut message boards while I wait for my Imagine to come in, and some people have been having some real issues with theirs, but so far so good. I was able to calibrate mine and print, put my inks in, and everything seems to be working fine. I've been able to use my older cartridges, and I think everything is good. So I'm gonna go ahead and point out a few things that I learned that may help others out there who are probably waiting for theirs to ship or hesitant about getting it. The first thing I learned was I stuck in both of my cartridges at the same time and my older cartridge wouldn't load up. So I went back to my user manual and it said you should load up one cartridge at a time. So I stuck in my Imagine Art cartridge first, had that load up on the screen. Once that was done, then I stuck in my older cartridge, in this case the Songbird cartridge. And look at the Imagine cartridge, it lights up, guys. Isn't that cool? Okay, and then I'm gonna try to zoom in on the screen here. So I'm gonna try to go back to the very first, like what you would see when you first load in your cartridges. So when you stick in your Imagine cartridge, you see the images on your display, and you can just slide your pen on the screen to see the different images on there. So really cool, some really nice images, and you can layer these and all that, and I'll be doing more videos on how that's done later as I learn, because I just took this out of the box. I don't know anything yet, but I do know that this section right here tells you, or at least this is how you would select different content. So what that means is this button over here is to see the content on the cartridge over here, which is in this case my Imagine cartridge, and then the button in the middle shows me the content that comes on my Imagine. So, and this is just mainly shapes, so show you some of those really quickly. Love the top note. And then this next button shows you what's on your cartridge over here, which in this case for me is my Songbird cartridge. There we go. And you can see all the different letters and whatnot. So that's how you toggle between your Imagine cartridge and your original Cricut cartridges. Now I'm going to show you how to put something on your mat. So I'm going to go with this shape from my Songbird cartridge. And I had an A on there before, but I'm actually going to get rid of that, so backspace. So now I have that image that I just selected down there. It shows up here, and then I'm just going to hit next. And it's going to show up on my mat. And one of the updates that I can't wait to happen is the ability to move this stuff around to anywhere I want to cut on my mat. So if I have a smaller sheet of paper that fits only this area of the mat, I can move the image down and utilize the paper from there. So right now you have to cut wherever it is. You can't move the image around. But you can edit it by clicking on it, and you get this screen, and you click on the pencil. And it brings you up into this editing screen here. Sorry guys, my hands are shaky. And you can either create your own color from here, or you can choose background content from your cartridges to fill in your shapes. And you could do this for your letters as well. And I'll show you what I mean by that. So we're going to apply that. And then I'm going to go back to my cartridge and I'm going to select maybe an uppercase one. I'll do the A. Shows up there. Hit next. It's going to show up on my mat. I'm going to edit it. And if I wanted it to be this polka dot blue, it looks polka dot. That's how I would change it. So you can make it different images, like different patterns, instead of just a full color. And I think that's pretty cool. Look at that. So amazing. Loving it so far. I have faith in ProvaCraft. When the Gypsy first came out, there were so many kinks that had to be worked out, and from us just complaining on the Cricut message boards, they were able to update the Gypsy, and I love my Gypsy to death. Like, it's perfect. Like, I don't have any problems with my Gypsy. So I know all the little kinks that need to be worked out with the Imagine. I have faith in ProvaCraft that they'll be able to work that out for us. So I'm happy with it so far, and I'll be making more videos as I continue to learn my Imagine, and hopefully someone will find these videos helpful. So this is my first Cricut Imagine video. Alright guys, thanks for watching. Bye!